Yo, what is up everybody, what's happening? DJ Kev here, back again with another video. Today we're gonna explore DJ Expo, one of the biggest DJ conventions in the US. Here we are with DJ Liv. Say what's up, Liv. She was kind enough to explore this DJ convention with me. Should be a big turnout. Last year there was COVID, so people were a little bit more reluctant to not be here. This year, I feel like it's gonna be a lot more people. I already saw the Instagram stories from last night. Looks like a lot of other YouTuber DJs are already here. So let's see who we can meet. We're gonna see what exhibits there are this year, and maybe there's some things we could buy. Maybe some new turntables, maybe some lights. Either way, very excited to see what's new out there in the DJ world. And without further ado, let's head in.
Start with the 505s and 808s ahead, Oscar.
All right, today we have DJ Bar. Welcome in DJ Bar to DJ Expo. Just a quick interview. Any tips for beginner DJs? Real quick, you don't gotta go all in, but.
Oh, that's a hard one. That's very generic. Ooh.
So you're saying we have no hope?
No, for beginner DJs, I would just say practice as much as possible and take any gig that comes your way, no matter how horrible it is. You got to pay your dues. Like, when I first started, bro, I remember doing some really bad gigs, but every gig is an experience, and you learn from every single one, especially if you're just starting out. So do every single gig you can and practice.
100%. Any must-play song right now that you have on a dance set that you've been playing lately that you're like, this is like hitting every time?
The entire Bad Bunny album. To be more specific, Después de la Playa, Titi Me Preguntó, Moscow Mule.
That's still
the whole album.
That's still like fire when you do Titi Me Pregunto to Toco Toco To. Like,
hell yeah.
I love that one.
The whole album is fire.
Who's your favorite DJ?
Avicii, Alesso, Alex Sensation.
Hey.
Those are my Miami.
Booty bouncing music.
Yeah.
Nah, it's more like a rave, right? You would say?
Alex Sensation is more like a Latin guy, so like,
yeah,
me,
that's true.
He does like open format. So that's kind of like the guy I looked up to the most when I was starting out. And then I feel like when we all get started, we always look up to, like, you know, those guys who are like just like impossible levels to reach, like Calvin Harris, Tiesto, Alesso. Those guys, that's just a whole nother level.
Oh yeah, 100%. And last thing, what's your favorite cartoon growing up?
Oh, The Simpsons.
Simpsons, really? Simpsons, I did,
yes,
not expect that.
Yes.
Simpsons, I don't know why I didn't expect that.
Yes.
But you do reference that a lot in your videos.
Yes. So I started watching The Simpsons even in Nicaragua.
Way back.
Yeah, so I watched The Simpsons in Spanish and then in the U.S. So The Simpsons, all-time greatest TV show of all time.
Appreciate your time, DJ Bar.
Yeah, let's do it, DJ Kev.
All right, everybody, another DJ Expo in the books. Very cool to see a lot of the content creators and other DJs that I look up to in person. They're all really kind, really humble, really genuine people. A couple people not showing this video that I was happy to see. I was able to see Santi, DJ Scooter, DJ Ragoza played a set with his wife while she was playing the guitar. That was really cool. And as usual, it's always nice to see DJ Bar and our crew at Bar Entertainment. The exhibits also did a great job showcasing their equipment. You were able to buy things like headphones, studio monitors, props, lights, accessories such as neon lights for your photo booth, or even a custom design for your laptop. Pioneer had a great exhibit. You're able to demo controllers such as the Rev 7, other turntables such as the PLX 1000, and for some controllers you were able to buy them right then and there. We also went to the RCF demo room. We were able to see and hear some speakers that weren't even released yet, and I may be biased because I have the RCF Evox J8s, but RCF really does make some high quality equipment. Now, while I personally didn't pull the trigger on any turntables or new controllers or lights, I'll show you just a few things that I was able to come home with. RCF string bag, RCF snapback, a free Pioneer DJ shirt, luggage tag, something to clean your electronics with, some DJ Expo merch, and a Wax On Rock and Soul t-shirt. I didn't buy much, majority of that stuff was free, but the Expo did have a lot of things to buy and offer. I was able to be around some of my favorite content creators, some industry leaders. Each and every one of them took some time to talk to me. And this convention just helps me appreciate the DJ culture that much more. And of course, I gotta shout out DJ Bar for taking the time to do this short interview with me and allowing me to hang out with you. I feel like it was a successful event, and I was happy to experience it. Hopefully I get to see the same people next year and some new faces as well. So my name is DJ Kev. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you made it to the end, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And follow me on Instagram to see what else I'm doing in the DJ world. Wishing you guys a successful rest of the year, and I'll catch you guys at the next video. Peace.